Your laptop computer is a powerful device, and it's really going to be the center of your music production activities. But the one thing to remember, in order to do anything with audio in a computer, we have to get audio in and out of the computer. Now, computers were not designed for audio production, and that's where an audio interface comes in. One of the most important decisions you'll make setting up your studio is getting an audio interface, choosing the right one. And there's a number of things that you can select from. There are a number of options at a variety of price points. So let's take a look at a very basic interface and see what are the features there that you would be using. First of all, if we take a look at this, it's very small, very portable. On the front panel, what we're going to see is there's one microphone input. It has an option here to turn phantom power on or off. If you are going to be using a condenser microphone, you will need an interface that has phantom power. Thankfully, most interfaces these days do have phantom power. This is also going to give you level control for that input. Now you'll have a separate input here for what we'll call a line input. And this is most likely going to be used if you're a guitarist or a bass player and you want to record your guitar directly into your DAW. And we have one additional knob here that allows us to control levels and a headphone output. Now on the back of this, this is a very simple interface. All I have is a USB connector, and then I have two RCA outputs. Now, RCA outputs are really semi-pro. You don't see these very often. You do see RCA connections sometimes in DJ equipment, but this is a type of output you have on this particular interface. You have many options, but this is a very simple, inexpensive way to get started. If we want to take a look at another interface, this is another interface by the same company, Focusrite. And this is going to give you a number of additional options which will be very useful. First of all, you have two inputs. So you have a microphone input, but if you take a look, we have a connector here that's called a Neutrik connector. And that connector will either take the XLR connection from a microphone cable or a quarter inch cable. So it really serves two different purposes. Now, for each of these inputs, I have a level control, allowing me to set the level directly from the front panel. I also have this 48 volt phantom power, which is an important part of any interface these days. And I have separate controls for monitor outputs going through your speakers or monitor outputs going through your headphones. These are two separate controls. It's very handy to have this available. And on the front panel, I do have my headphone connection. So the nice thing about this interface design is that everything that you're going to need to do is pretty much on the front panel. You only really need to go to the back panel to make some additional connections. So as we're looking back, what we're going to see is this is a USB interface, but I have a few different options for inputs and outputs. I have a line input here, which I can use to connect external devices, let's say a hardware synth or drum machine, and I have separate outputs. So I have outputs 1 and 2, which I would typically connect to my monitor speakers. I have two additional outputs that I could use to connect to another set of speakers if I wanted to. Now, the other thing that's really cool about this interface is it does have a what we'll call standard MIDI connections. These are 5-pin DIN connections that were part of the original MIDI spec. There's a lot of hardware that was made between 1983 and now, and much of that hardware uses this type of 5-pin connection. So this is a really great option to have on your audio interface. And in that sense, the interface works both as an audio interface and as a MIDI interface. This is pretty much a good set of features for most people to start with. Now from there, there are a lot of other interfaces that give you more professional features. So this one here from Motu, Mark of the Unicorn, gives you a very simple, very basic front panel. It gives you a single microphone input, two different line inputs, controls for those. The thing that's interesting about this and what makes it such a powerful device is it gives you a lot of different options for inputs and outputs. We have 6 different analog inputs. We have 6 different analog outputs. So if I wanted to connect a number of different hardware devices, we could really use this as an interface that would bring things in and out of the computer. So we could really use the computer more as a mixer. I have main outs, and these would be where my speakers are connected. In addition to USB, I also have an Ethernet connection, which enables you to use this for high-speed connectivity on an audio network called an AVB network. So this is something that you probably won't be using in your home, but it allows you to digitally network a whole series of devices. I also have digital inputs and outputs if I wanted to do direct digital connections. We don't see this too much these days, but in higher-end professional settings, you might be using this. And then once again, we have these traditional MIDI inputs and outputs. So this particular interface would be useful if you are having a more full-featured studio, if you're integrating more inputs, more outputs, and really using your computer as the centerpiece and using this interface to bring audio signals in and out of your computer. So these are just a few of the many different audio interfaces available. As you make your choice, think about what you're going to be doing now. Think about what you may be doing in a few years, how you might be growing your studio. And just about anything you get these days will really serve you well.